God is good all the time. Put a song of praise in this heart.
Thank you to all our viewers. We hope you are all staying safe and staying strong in the Lord. We are thankful to the Lord for a wonderful and anointed FGCCI media service last week, especially the message by Pastor Victor Sithu, entitled Authority. Let us remember the words of Jesus found in Luke chapter 10, verse 19. Behold, I give you the authority to trample on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Praise the Lord. I am Sister Florence, your presider for this week. Be strong, the Lord, found in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10, is our theme for 2021. Let us continue to be strong in the Lord together during these challenging times. May the good Lord continue to use us to be a blessing to many and even into the nation. Amen. Let us continue to be united in prayer for Malaysia and the nation till the pandemic is over. Remember to always exercise greater caution and self-discipline to stay safe by the grace of God, even as Klang Valley has moved to phase 4 of the National Recovery Plan and even interstate travel is now allowed. However, let us continue to keep our nation in earnest prayers for a full recovery and for economic revival. Praise the Lord. Many thanks once again for all your earnest prayers and faithful support for our digital discipleship church program. Let us also be encouraged by God's promise found in Philippians chapter 4, verse 6 to 7. Be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Hallelujah! And our presenter for this week are the following. The scripture reading is by Sister Grace Ong. Worship leading is by Brother Julius Bonifacio. Exhortation is by Sister Dana Winson. Praise the Lord. Prayer for the nation of Iraq will be led by Pastor Asad Biki from FGCCI Main Church. The Word of God will be shared by Reverend Dr. Bernard Ong, an apostolic missionary to the nations. Closing a benediction will be conducted by Reverend Dr. David Gray, Senior Pastor and Spiritual Overseer of FGCCI. Praise the Lord. Hope you will be abundantly blessed this year. Stay tuned, church, and God bless us all, and stay safe.
Today's scripture reading is taken from Romans 8, verse 31-39. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can against us? He did not spare his own son, but delivered him up for us all. How shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall bring a charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is he who condemns? It is Christ who died, and furthermore, it also raised, who is even at the right hands of God, who also made intercessions for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulations or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? As it is written, for your sake we are killed all day long, we are accounted as sheep for the slaughter. Yet in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loves us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life nor angels nor principality nor powers nor things present nor things to come, no height, no depth, no any other great things shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. May the Lord bless the reading of His word. Amen.
God is good. God is good.
Good morning, church, and all our viewers. Let's continue to presence, Lord.
You.
Let's continue to worship the Lord. Thank you and God bless.
God is good all the time. He put a song of praise.
Good morning, church, and all our viewers. The title of my exhortation today is Living the Christ-Centered Life. What is the secret to living the Christ-centered life? I would like to share a few from Paul's letter to the Colossians from chapter 2 to 4. Number 1, faith that is rooted, built up and strengthened in Christ. Colossians chapter 2 verse 6 to 7 says, "So then, just as you received Christ, Jesus as Lord, continue to walk in Him, rooted and built up in Him, strengthened in the faith as you were taught, and overflowing with thankfulness." Christian life is founded on faith in Christ Jesus and all the treasures of wisdom and knowledge hidden in Him. We should continue walk in His ways, be rooted and build up deeply on Him. We go spiritually through His word and power of Holy Spirit. We practically strengthen in our faith as we commit to obey His word and walk in spirit and truth. The result of being rooted and built up is a heart that is filled with overflowing with thankfulness. We also stand firm on the truth and avoiding being influenced by man's philosophy or human tradition which conflict with the word of God. Don't be deceived by false teachers or cultural issues. Colossians chapter 2 verse 8 says, "Beware lest anyone cheat you through philosophy and empty deceit, according to the tradition of men, according to the basic principles of the world, and not according to Christ." Number 2, setting our mind on heavenly things. Colossians chapter 3 verse 1 to 2 says, "Keep seeking the things above, where Christ is, sitting at the right hand of God. Set your mind on things above, not on the things that are on the earth." This exhorts us to be spiritually minded. We are called to keep our minds on things that are above and not to be influenced by the things of the earth, and live by trusting in Jesus, not by trusting in our own abilities. We are to find our sufficiency in Christ, knowing that in this world we will have tribulation, but Christ has overcome the world and we have a priceless inheritance that can never perish, spoil or fade away. An inheritance that is kept in heaven especially for us. Number 3, clothing ourselves with compassion. Colossians chapter 3 verse 12 to 14 says, "Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourself with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness and patience, bearing with each other and forgive one another if any of you has a grievance against someone. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these things, put on love, which is the bond of perfection." As God's chosen people, we are to be holy, for He is holy. We are to put on a heart of compassion and bring forth the spiritual fruit of kindness, humility, gentleness, patience, and we are to bear with one another in love, forgiving each other just as God in Christ has forgiven us. Point number 4, letting the peace of God rule in our heart. Colossians chapter 3 verse 15 says, "Let the peace of Christ rule in your heart, since as member of one body you were called to peace and be thankful." This both commands inner peace and being thankful. We promote peace within us and around us with an attitude of gratitude, appreciating our blessings, instead of taking them for granted as our right. Point number 5, devoting ourselves to prayer. Colossians chapter 4 verse 2 says, devote yourself to prayer, being watchful and thankful. This encourages a prayerful attitude, not relying on our own strength, but taking our life to God for His blessing and providence to help. We should pray likewise for others. Conclusion, we are called to walk worthy of the Lord and to be fruitful in our Christian life, but this can only be achieved as we rooted, build up in Him, rest in Him, and walk in spirit and truth. We also submit to the leading and guidance of Holy Spirit in our lives to continue to grow in grace and knowledge of Jesus Christ. God bless all and take care.
All the time, through the darkest night, His light will shine.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, Rabba, 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 Shanduru, Rossi, Kere, Andara, Mara, Sikhe. Jesus, 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 Nasri, Ke Naam, Se, Yehova, Paap, Kudamand. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Kudamand, Hum, Tere, Shukar, Guzari, Karte, Hain. और तेरे नाम को इज्जत और जलाल देते हैं, प्रस्तुति सजदे जबी हम वडियाई तारीफ तेरे लिए यीशु मसीह नासरी के नाम से खुदावंद आज सुबह खुदावंद मैं तेरे नाम को इज्जत और जलाल देता हूँ अपनी सारी टीम के लिए, अपने सारे चर्च के लिए, जितने लोग इसको देखें, जितने लोग इस दुआ को सुने और खुदावंद जितने लोग इस सर्विस को आज ज्वाइन करें, खुदावंद वो बरकत पाएं यीशु के नाम से। और पाकर खुदावंद खासतौर पर मैं तेरे हुजूर में आता हूँ इराक के लिए, खुदावंद बल्कि इराक को खुदावंद हम तेरे हाथों में रखते हैं यीशु मसीह नासरी के नाम से। खुदावंद जो हमारे मिशनरी वो खुदावंद हमारे जो बहन भाई वहाँ पर काम कर रहे हैं वो खुदावंद तेरी कलाम की सच्चाई को बयान कर रहे हैं, वो खुदावंद तेरे खुदावंद तेरे कलाम को लोगों के साथ शेयर कर रहे हैं। खुदावंद फजल दे उनकी ये मेहनत, खुदावंद रंग लाए, ओ खुदावंद बहुत सारे लोगों को जीत कर तेरे गल्ला में शामिल करने वाले बन जाएं यीशु मसीह नासरी के नाम से। यीशु मसीह नासरी के नाम से अब आप हम उस मुल्क को तेरे हाथों में रख देते हैं, उसकी गवर्नमेंट को तेरे हाथों में रखते हैं। ओ खुदावंद कंट्रोल कर उस सारे मुल्क को यीशु मसीह नासरी के नाम से। खुदावंद जब तक हमारे लोग उस मुल्क में रहते हैं, ओ खुदावंद FGCCI के लोग वहाँ पर हैं, ओ खुदावंद FGCCI मिशनरी वहाँ पर हैं, तो खुदावंद तेरा अबर, तेरा जोर, तेरी कुदरत, तेरी फेवरेट पर बनी रहे यीशु के नाम से। खुदावंद ओ खुदावंद तो अपने जलाल को ज़ाहिर कर, अपनी कुदरत को नाजिल फरमा यीशु मसीह नासरी के नाम से। यहोवा पाक खुदावंद तेरे चेहरे का नूर उन पर जलवा करो और तेरे नाम को इज्जत और जलाल मिले। खुदावंद पाक खुदावंद यीशु के नाम से। ओ रबा रा शेंदे रे रे बेरे खेरे अंदुरो रो। ओ खुदावंद आज हम तेरे लोगों के साथ मिलकर, ओ खुदावंद चर्च के साथ मिलकर मुत्तफिक होते हुए दुआ करते हैं, ओ खुदावंद एक रिवाइवल को मांग लेते हैं। इसी तरह खुदावंद अपनी सारी टीम के लिए, पास्टर डेविड कोई के लिए, ओ खुदावंद सारी टीम के लिए जो जिनको वो लीड कर रहे हैं, ओ खुदावंद हम तेरे हुजूर में लेकर आते हैं यीशु मसीह नासरी के नाम से। मलेशिया के लिए खुदावंद बरकत और सलामती की दुआ करते हैं यीशु मसीह नासरी के नाम से। आ यहोवा पाक खुदावंद, आ यीशु के नाम से, यीशु के नाम से। ओ रबा रा शेंदे रे बेरे सेखे रे रे अंदुरु। ओ जीसस, 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 यीशु के नाम से, यीशु के नाम से। तेरा जलाल ठहर जाए, तेरी कुदरत काम करना शुरू हो जाए। खुदावंद उस मुल्क को मैं तेरे हाथों में दे देता हूँ यीशु के नाम से। खुदावंद जितने लोग हमारे वहाँ पर हैं उनका खुदावंद वहाँ पर मेहनत करना, मुनादी करना, पाए से बरकत हो, बहुत सारे लोगों को जीत कर तेरे गल्ला में शामिल करने वाले बन सके यीशु मसीह नासरी के नाम से। ये दुआ मांगते हैं, पा लेते हैं।
A very good morning to you, dear church, fellow viewers, and brothers and sisters in the body of Christ. This morning, I'd like to talk with you concerning the importance of thinking before we speak. Why? Well, for a simple reason, a lot of relationships are adversely affected because of the way one party or two parties speak without thinking. I have been a banker before, and in my career as a bank manager, I have experienced and seen how staff and customer got into misunderstanding, or even colleagues, they do misunderstood one another and the relationship became sour. And most important of all, I noticed through my counseling of couples all these years that a lot of couples do not talk properly, and that is attributed to the fact they do not really think through before they utter those words. Likewise, between bosses and their workers, or owner of big factories and their staff, sometimes the failure of a relationship, as we often find, is caused by our failure to never think through before we utter our word. More often, it is due to the fact that we react rather than responding. Notice that husband and wife, in the beginning, when they are courting, it was beautiful communication because both parties are very careful in the way they present themselves. They want to make sure that there is no misunderstanding, that their friendship begins to grow and become a good, strong, and lasting relationship. And subsequently, when they walk down the aisle and marry as husband and wife, because of challenges in their new home and challenges in their own workplace, many a times you'll find because of what they had gone through when they communicate with their loved ones, particularly between spouses, they do not be very careful any longer. They just speak how they feel, but they did not think through before they utter a single word. That resulted in misunderstanding and often a lot of pain, which begins to strain the relationship. And it is therefore very important for you and me that we observe these biblical principles of thinking before speaking. I like to draw your attention to James chapter 1, verses 19 to 20, where the Apostle James spoke to us. So then, my beloved brethren, let every man be swift to hear, slow to speak, slow to wrath, for the wrath of man does not produce the righteousness of God. This is a strong reminder for we guys and ladies that we must always listen first. We must always think through. We must search our heart even before we speak. If we are too fast in speaking forth whatever word we have used and it has gone forth, we will not be able to retract and take them back. Now notice, we have 2 years, but we have only a lip, a mouth. So we must be very careful to remind ourselves, listening is more important than speaking. Likewise, when we observe our two lips, you will realize that the purpose of the two lips is to pronounce the word. So we use the lips to speak. So before that, you find that we got two sets of teeth that also serve as guarding the word that we are about to speak. And likewise, our tongue. We need to use our tongue and our vocal voice in order to be able to speak forth the word that hopefully would come from our heart and our thinking through rather than our emotion. Sad to say that many marriages have broken down because the relationship between two persons who were once happily married, have great courtship, but after marriage, you find that the relationship begins to deteriorate. So here is a reminder. We got 2 years, but only one mouth. And even before one single word comes forth, it says go through our vocal cord, then our tongue, then our two set of teeth, and our lips. So vitally important also is how we say it. Do we say it in a well-mannered way? Do we speak out politely? Or do we just blurt out due to our emotion? Emotion and feeling are unreliable. You have to be in control. And I too must discipline my emotion and my feeling because they are real, but they can be wrong. And if we are not careful with our feeling, our emotion, then we will regret for saying things that we should not have spoken, and that will cause our relationship with the other person to continue to erode, which we should not. Because everyone that God brought into our life is to help us, is to cause us to become better people. For iron sharpens iron. And as a man, as a woman, we must be very aware of that. Imagine a very beautiful lady. Beautiful, people admire. But if she doesn't think before she speaks, and once she has spoken wrongly or without thinking through, people would have a wrong impression of her, a bad impression, in spite of the fact that she may look presentable. Such can be the man too. And more often than that, it happened to the man. The wife talk and the man never think through and just reacted instead of responding. Not listening, but just want to speak. And because we as men fail to be good listeners, our relationship will certainly take told. So therefore, remember James 1:19-20. So brethren, my beloved, let every man be swift to hear, slow to speak, slow to wrath, for the wrath of man does not produce the righteousness of God. So be righteous by being a great listener before you speak. Pay attention when someone speaks to us. Fix your gaze upon the person's eyes and let your both ear tune to what he or she is trying to communicate with you. Why then must we think before we speak? Well, Matthew 12:36-37, according to the Bible, which we believe is the word of God, it says, but I say to you that every idle word man may speak, they will give account of it in the day of judgment. For by your words you will be justified, and by your word you will be condemned. Very serious. So don't speak idle word, and don't speak words that does not encourage. Don't speak words that will tear but ensure. We speak words that will encourage in an encouraging way. We speak words that will build the hearer. Amen. Right? Let me give you several reasons why it is important to be a good listener and a slow speaker. Number one, notice in the book of Proverbs, our words are powerful. Proverbs 12:18, for an example, it says that reckless words pierce like a sword, but the tongues of the wise brings healing. Imagine your words can be very cutting, and your word can be very soothing and ministering, healing. Amen. Proverbs 15:1-4, another example. A gentle answer turns away wrath, but a harsh word stirs up anger. The tongue of the wise makes knowledge acceptable, but the mouth of the fools sprouts folly. The eyes of the Lord are in every place, watching the evil and the good. A soothing tongue is a tree of life, but perversion in it crushes the spirit. Wow, wow, wow. God's word is spirit and life, and it is very powerful here. Be gentle when we speak, because it will turn away anger. Do not be harsh with our word. And he continued to say, if we are wise, then we will make the knowledge that we are imparting acceptable. But the mouth of fools just simply spouts out folly. And realize God is watching. So let us speak properly. Make sure we do not hurt the listener, be it our spouse, be it our parent, be it our children, be it our boss, be it our workers, be it the customer, be it maybe a waiter or waitresses in the restaurant, or be it a coffee shop owner or the meat seller, because our words are really powerful. Proverbs 18:6-7 is another example. A fool's lips bring strife. Notice it. The foolish word we speak out will cause strife. And the mouth and his mouth of the fool invite a beating. A full mouth is his undoing, and his lips are a snare to his soul. So your lips should be a blessing. It should not become a trap, a snare to your soul. And most of all, it should not create strife. How you say and what you say, think through, for goodness sake. For this is the teaching of God's word. Let me give another example in Proverbs 18:20-21. From the fruits of his mouth, a man's stomach is filled. With the harvest from his lips, your lips will bring harvest, and you will be satisfied. The tongue has the power of life or and death, and those who love it will eat its fruits. Oh, herein is a strong reminder for me and for you. Secondly, why we must listen more than we speak. Why we must be quick to listen when someone speaks to us, rather than reacting or responding rashly without thinking through. Proverbs 15:28 say, the heart of the righteous weighs its answer, but the fool of the wicked gushes evil. Isn't it true? If you are a man who wants to walk in righteousness, you want to live correctly, then you weigh your answer, you weigh your word before you share it out. Never gush out your word. It's supposed to go through your vocal cord, your tongue, your two sets of teeth, and your sets of lips. And so check your heart, check your mind, think through before you speak forth, because it will get us into unnecessary trouble if we are careless in our speaking. Proverbs 18:2 also say, a fool finds no pleasures in understanding, but delights in airing his own opinions. Very often, when our spouse says something, instead of really paying attention to listen and think through, we just want to air our opinion. And that is not wise. After all, that is our spouse. Every relationship ought to be treasured, and we must always remember that. Proverbs 18:13 say, he who answers before listening, that is his folly and shame. There are some people, you know, before really hearing and listening through and thinking through, they just speak for an answer, and that become his folly, and we bring about shame. Proverbs 20:25, Don't trap yourself by a rash promise to God and only later counting the cost. And so our words can get us into unnecessary trouble. Never promise. Never give any promise if we are not sure we can fulfill it. The third reason why we must be quick to listen, slow to speak, and we must think through before we speak is we must be in control over our words. What's the point if you are in control of a nation, but as a prime minister, as a president, you're not in control of your word? Now let's look at Proverbs 10:19. When words are many, sin is not absent, but he who holds his tongue is wise. So it is wise for you to hold your tongue. Feel like lashing out, feel like speaking out of emotion and out of your feeling, hold it, control it. Because the more you speak and the quicker you speak, you will tend to make mistakes. Proverbs 21:23. He who guards his mouth and his tongue keeps himself from calamity. If you do not want to have mishap in your relationship, in your family, in your business, guard your mouth and make sure you are in control of your words. Amen. Proverbs 17:27-28 say, a man of knowledge uses words with restraint, and a man of understanding is even-tempered. Even the fool is thought wise if he keeps silent, and he is thought to be discerning if he holds his tongue. Are you wise? Are you discerning? To be wise and discerning, we must use our words with restraint. Be choosy about your words. Think through. And not only the choice of your word, the tone of your word, together with your non-verbal expression. Amen. The fourth reason why we must be quick to listen, slow to speak is this. We need to loosen our tongues. Proverbs 12:25. An anxious heart weighs a man down, but a kind word cheers him up. So loosen your tongue. In other words, don't be too tight. Alright? Loosen your tongue. Loosen your teeth and your lips. And speak kindly. Alright? Speak thoughtfully. Think through before we speak. Proverbs 15:23 say, a man finds joy in giving an apt reply. And how good is a timely word. So our reply must be thought through. Is it apt? And is it timely? Maybe during a misunderstanding and both husband and wife are quarreling, maybe you, even though you are right, but there is a time to speak for. So when the time is for you to listen, so that the other party know that you have hear, you have heard and listened to him or to her. And so your word should be timely, should not come out of your mouth too early, nor too late. Proverbs 25 verse 15, gold there is, and rubies in abundance, but lips that speak knowledge are a rare jewel. I hope that we will appreciate that. We must speak knowledge because it's a real jewel to the listener. Do you own much gold, much ruby? How I wish you have, how I wish I have. But even when we do not have much gold or rubies, our lips can serve like rare jewel. And whenever you are about to speak, people will want to listen because they are nuggets like gold and ruby, sapphire, emerald. They are like very rare jewel, better than those jewelries and all the rubies and all those precious stones on the crowns of our dear exemplary Queen Elizabeth of Great Britain. We and our mouth can become like jewel for people whom we are talking to. Proverbs 27 verse 5, an open rebuke is better than hidden love. So loosen your tongue when it's the time for you to give a loving and gentle and a timely rebuke. Let it come forth in a presentable manner rather than hidden love. Because if we love, then we will also correct in love. Amen. The fifth reason why you and I must be quick to listen and slow to speak is to remember our words must start in our heart. Our words should come from our heart. So have a loving heart, have a thoughtful heart, have a considerate heart, have a kind heart, have a most joyous heart, peaceful heart before we speak. Proverbs 4:23. Keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it spring the issues of life. The heart is where the issues of life are. If your heart is not rich, you can have all the riches in the whole wide world. You can be a great banker. You can be a wealthy man where you gain the whole world and you have the whole world in your hand. You are rich, you're wealthy, but your heart is not rich. You're stingy. You are poor in your heart. You're not generous, not rich, not kind, not loving. Where? What happened? That is where the issue of life are lodged. So remember, our words must start in our heart. So next time before we speak, make sure it comes from the heart, not our feeling, not out of our unhappy emotion, our critical attitude. No, No, certainly not. Matthew 12, 34, and the second part of 34 say, for out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speak. I want to encourage you. Whenever I share the word of God, whenever I talk to someone, whenever I preach the word of God, I got to make sure that it comes out from the abundance of my heart. If there is no love, if there is no good intention, if there is no consideration, if there is no kindness, if there are if it is judgmental, if it is critical, it is something that we must be aware. It is out of the abundance of our heart, our mouth speaks. So always speak from the richness of your heart. And only God can give us a very good and loving heart. And we must seek to develop our heart by knowing the hearts of God, by spending quality time in the presence of God. Because the more time you spend with the loving God that we serve, the more loving you will become. So believing in the Lord Jesus Christ is a very basic foundation. But after being a Christian, you know, the way we say things, how we say it, the tone with which you say, the non-verbal expressions, shown forth when we speak, actually reveal how close do we walk with God, how much depth we have of the Word of God, how much depth we must feed on God's Word. We must fill our heart with the Word of God. For God's Word is spirit and life, without which we cannot impart the Spirit of God, we cannot impart life to other people. Amen. Praise God. Now, number six, it is important we be good, be quick to listen, and slow to speak because of our heart. Remember, be watchful of your heart. Check your heart. Do I still love my spouse? Do I really love my parent? Do I really love my daughter? Do I really love my friend? For it is out of the heart and out of its abundance, a person will speak. So be watchful of your heart. Now, I just want to share with you this well-known saying, except that I added the top part. It goes like this: watch your hearts, for they become your thoughts. Watch your thoughts, for they become your words. And watch your words, for they become your action. And watch your action, for they become your habits. And watch your habits, for they become your character. And of course, watch your character, for they become your destiny. Now, whether we end up with what we believe, that there is a God and we have a Savior, whether we end up in the place called heaven, all depends upon our heart of faith, our heart of belief, our heart of trust, our heart of dependency, our heart of loving God with all our heart, our soul, our strength, our mind, and to love our neighbor as ourselves. Our heart to love God and obey His command to go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, teaching them all I've commanded you. And Lord, I'm with you always. So be watchful of your heart. Number 7, always remember we must be quick to listen, slow to speak. And this concluding remark I'm going to make is, your words are really powerful. P-O-W-E-R-F-U-L. Let me elaborate. Now listen, for I'm going to close pretty soon until I meet you another time. Church, listen. A careless word may kindle strife. A cruel word may wretch alive. A bitter word may instill hate. A brutal word may smite and kill. Now praise God. A gracious word may smooth the way. A joyous word may light the day. A gentle word may turn angers away. A well-spoken word may clear the way. A timely word may lessen stress. And a lovely word may heal and bless. May our words be always gracious, joyous, gentle, well-spoken, timely, and lovely. Let us not be careless with our word, be cruel in our word, be bitter in our word, and be brutal in our word. That is why I keep reminding you and me, and I repeat it, check our heart. Do we really have the love of God? Are we a loving man? Are we a loving woman? Are we a loving employee? Are we a loving employer? Are we a loving pastor? Are we a loving leader? Are we a loving members? Are we a loving neighbor? Are we a loving friend? Are we a loving customer? Our words are really powerful. So think true and true before we speak. So in conclusion, be slow in speaking, but be quick to listen. Let us listen more than speaking. We should speak when we need to speak, but let us be quick to speak, but be slow to speak. And when we speak, let us make sure we use the right tone, we have the right words that we are weighing, and also at the right time. Therefore, before you and I speak again from now onward, let us think through. The word think, T-H-I-N-K, S-I-N-K. T, talk about truthfulness. Ask the question, is it true? The word H, T-H, is it, talk about helpfulness. Is the word we are about to speak helpful to the listener or to those in the group? I, T-H-I, inspiration, is what we are about to speak inspiring to the listener or to the company of saints or to the company of friends that we are fellowshipping. N, T-H-I-N, talk about necessity. Is it necessary? What I'm about to respond or to say something, is it necessary? Or my keeping quiet will be better? Is it necessary to add on or to reframe? So we have to ask that question about necessity. And finally, K, talk about kindness. Is what we're going to say kind? Is our word filled with kindness? So, is it true? Is it helpful? Is it inspiring? Is it necessary? And is it kind? Look at my lips. Remember, this lips can be used as rare jewel. These lips and this set of teeth and your tongue and your vocal voice and your heart can become like choice or rare jewels. And I pray that we will be genuine follower of the Lord Jesus Christ, so that our family members, our relatives, our church brothers and sisters, our neighbors, our friends, our acquaintances, and even our customer and those who serve us will be able to see the love and the reality of God. James 1:19-20, our key verses. So then, my beloved church pastors, leaders, my beloved brothers and sisters in Christ, dear friends in the body of Christ, dear brethren, let every man be swift to hear, slow to speak, slow to be angry, for the wrath of man does not produce the righteousness of God. In everything we do, and most of all, with our words, let us be righteous for His glory and for His kingdom. And may God bless you abundantly. And I pray, dear church, fellow viewer, and brothers and sisters in the body of Christ worldwide, think before we speak. Thinking before speaking is very important. And let us be rich in our heart with God, with His love, with His Word, and let us be filled with His very presence, and especially the sweet, blessed Holy Spirit who abides in us. May we allow the Holy Spirit to check our attitude, our behavior, our conduct, so that out of the abundance of our heart, everything that we say, it will be righteousness, and that it will be glorifying to the Lord our God and for the kingdom of God, that it may bring glory and honor to our Lord. Once again, it is my real joy, and thank you, Pastor, for giving me this wonderful honor of sharing and talking to your congregation that you love, the very Word of God.
Good morning, church, and all the viewers. Thank you for tuning in to FGCCI Media Channel. I hope that you are richly blessed by this week's media service. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank all the presenters for their wonderful efforts, especially Sister Florence for her wonderful and cheerful presiding always, and also Sister Grace Ong for her wonderful scripture reading from Romans chapter 8. And I just want to read from verse 38. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. What a wonderful and great promise of God's love for us. I also want to thank Brother Julius for his wonderful worship leading, and we are also blessed by the presence of God as we worship together. I also want to especially thank Sister Dana for her excellent and insightful exhortation entitled Living a Christ-Centered Life. Truly, we must be focused on Christ, and we must continue to live a Christ-centered life so that we can grow to greater spiritual maturity. Praise the Lord. Also, especially want to thank Pastor Asad Vicky for his prayer for the nation of Iraq. Thank you so much. I want to take this opportunity to specially thank our speaker this week, Reverend Dr. Bernard Ong, for his excellent and powerfully anointed message entitled Think Before You Speak from the book of James. It is so full of wisdom and so full of insight. And in summary, I just want to read from 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16. All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be complete, thoroughly equipped for every good work. I also want to read Ephesians chapter 4, verse 15. But speaking the truth in love, may grow up in all things into Him who is the head, Christ. And as well as James chapter 3, verse 2. For we all stumble in many things. If anyone does not stumble in word, he is a perfect man, able also to bridle the whole body. Praise the Lord for an excellent message today. Think before we speak. And that's why Bible exhorts us to quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to anger. And as you know, that everyone is growing. If you are the born-again Christians, you don't immediately become mature. You have to have the stages of growth, like a new baby. that is born, it takes time to grow. So same in all Christians also takes time to grow to maturity. And because of that, we all many times will make mistakes in our speech or even in our actions, especially in the way we speak, because we are not yet mature. As James chapter 3 verse 2 say, we're able to bridle our tongue, then we will be considered perfect or mature. He says, if anyone does not stumble in word, he is a perfect man. Here the word perfect means mature. So we need to understand this truth that everyone is in a stage of growth and in a stage of moving towards maturity. Our Christians is desiring to move towards maturity, and it takes time. And because of that, we do stumble in our word, do make mistakes in the way we speak. But today's message will help us very much, especially the acronym about THINK. It will be very helpful for us to think before we speak. But at the same time, we have to understand that we are growing. And everyone who is born again Christians, they are still growing in the Lord, and they does make mistakes. And we ourselves do make mistakes. Even myself, I still do make mistakes in my speech or in my words. So the important thing is to know when we make mistakes in our speech, what must we do? We must be quick to apologize. Sometimes we may speak things wrongly or unintentionally say words that may hurt others, and we know it or we realize it later, we should apologize. Able to say sorry or able to apologize is a great hallmark of maturity as well. I forgot how many times I say sorry to my wife or sorry to people whom I intentionally speak words that does not edify them or unintentionally offended them. I have to apologize. And I realize that many times if you were to say sorry to people because of the wrong words that we unintentionally or maybe too hastily spoken, people were able to accept the apology and they will be merciful. Most of the time, I can see that people are merciful. And also, we must be merciful to ourselves. If we do err in our words or stumble in our words, don't condemn ourselves, but just realize that we are all still growing to maturity. And do be merciful to others and be merciful to ourselves, even as we take the steps of correction to apologize when we said something wrong. And then we can learn from our mistakes, and we'll learn to bridle our tongue. That's why the book of James said that we need to learn to bridle our tongue like a horse. It takes time to tame a horse, it takes time to tame the tongue. We are able to tame the tongue and able to speak wisely and able to speak correctly, and then we become a mature man. We will make less mistakes in our speech. I hope that this short summary will bless your hearts today. And as usual, we're going to give our tithes and offerings to the Lord. Let us pray. The Heavenly Father, as we lift up, Lord, these tithes and these offerings and this love gift before thy throne of grace, bless, Lord, these tithes and this offering and this love gift. Bless every giver, Lord, and return back your blessings upon them, 100-fold, 60-fold, and 30-fold now. May your name be greatly magnified and glorified in the nations of the world. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you once again for your earnest prayer and faithful support. We are all so blessed. I'd like to give you a benediction before we conclude this week's service. Just close our eyes and hearken to the benediction for this week. May the Lord bless you and may the Lord keep you. The Lord cause His face to shine upon you and be gracious towards you. May the Lord lift up His countenance upon you and grant you peace. The Lord stretch off his hands of favor and of blessings and of providence and of protections upon you and your family and upon your loved ones. May you learn to bridle your tongue and not stumble in your word and grow to greater maturity and able to speak words that edify, words that builds up, words that truly be a blessing to the hearers. And may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forevermore. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Thank you, church and all the viewers, once again for tuning in to FGCCI Media Channel. I hope to see you again next week for the communion service as well, that is next week. And remember to always stay safe, stay blessed, and stay strong in the Lord together.
Cheese.